And about 10 years ago, I met Liliana Jimenez and Laurent Labellego at a conference, and we began talking about hydration. And I realized that they had a vision. And their vision was that they might form a conference which would involve scientists focusing on hydration research.
10 years ago, we had an ambitious idea. We wanted to bring together the world's greatest scientific minds and specialists in hydration to address a problem.
I go from year after year expecting that, you know, somebody will talk about water, so that you're like, probably you don't even need water, you just drink some milk. It seems like we forget about water.
Some people do talk about water and daily fluid intake in the media, but no one seems to agree, and it's a real mess.
Water, water, water. Okay, so let's go over this together. Thirsty means drink, not so thirsty, you're good to go. Got it?
People were talking about hydration, but not necessarily clearly. Surely a subject so essential, so vital, deserves better. So we created Hydration for Health.
What I think is really unique very interesting is the ability over years to have built a community.
In the years that followed, we've grown, and as we've got bigger, so too did our house. And we're still growing.
After 9 years, it is still the unique international scientific conference addressing the issue of hydration and health for the large majority of the world population. So that's an event that appears nowhere else in the world.
Yet, like all good architects, we've got an eye firmly on the future as well.
I believe that water intake and its effect on health is going to be the biggest medical breakthrough of the last 50 years.
Because this project is much bigger than us, and to succeed, and must be built to last long into the future. In 10 years, we've come a long way already.
This conference is the only one in the world where people from all over gather to discuss all aspects of hydration, to discuss with people whose papers we read and who we admire, and to really dive further into the subject.
So we wanted to say thank you. We may have built the house, but it's you that made it a home.